because he mentions a couple organizations that we're going to supposed to just assume, well, they definitely must be coaching people and sending them in directly. He doesn't even attempt to make the case. He just says, yeah, there it is. Go ahead, conclude it yourself. Seems to be pretty flimsy.
Yes, it is.
Wow. So what was the other one he did in here where he just flat out speculates about this, the birthers? Oh, okay.
Oh, the birthers and the people opposing socialized or government-run health care are one and the same.
Yeah. I think we don't know how many protesters are birthers, but it wouldn't be surprising that if it's a substantial fraction. Therefore, again, trying to marginalize people, it's as if I'm reading this, and let's say I'm against the Obama plan, and I would go, wow, I'm against it, but I wouldn't want to become a protester since most protesters are birthers. I wouldn't want to be associated with them. As if people are going to think that. But he doesn't even know. He's just throwing it out there. It's just some idle, hopeful speculation. It's more like a delusion.
There's bound to be some crossover, but I think that's a really flimsy supposition.
Again, desperate. I mean, if you can't bring some evidence, if you just bring a bunch of suspicions and I think you see the statist activists, especially in the media, they have to come up with a reaction pretty quick. They usually do not have time in our quick news cycle to go out and actually gather evidence, so they make these speculations and insinuations trying to psychoanalyze the other side. If they can't understand why the other side would be against growing the government, they just immediately revert to either they must be racist or they must be kooks, you know, who believe in some far-fetched conspiracy. or worse.
It just doesn't fly.
Yeah, and then just to say, well, yeah, okay, they must be racist, and that's it. He's just trying to scare her and intimidate, and that's it's funny. Yeah. Anyway, it's actually good news to me because it looks like the thing is has in the last week has gone under 50% in terms of popularity, and then the panic is starting to set in, I think. And if they really believed in what they had, and they could just, why couldn't you just continue to argue for it? I mean, like I've said before, I'm pro-life, but I don't want to have draconian, you know, rules. I'd rather just see people just not engage in the behavior. You know, find a way to avoid it. And it's something like, if you're going to argue your side, just argue your side and don't get desperate and try to characterize the other side as demonic in some way. It's I can do it for a joke. I don't know if you saw the poster going around of Obama with the Joker face. They've been putting them up around here in L.A., and they've been putting now them up around the country, and yeah, it doesn't really follow. I mean, other than, you know, that the Joker was pretty, you know, ambitious and not really, you know, very quite selfish in his thing. You might insinuate that about Obama, but you might insinuate his policies ultimately are a joke too, where he could just spend us into oblivion, you know, for the most short-term game you can, and then let the future be damned. And yeah, well, you could make the insinuation, but I think the derision of the other side, it can get pretty nasty. Apparently there's some battles already going on in these town halls that the SIEU and other kind of leftist organizations or statist organizations are showing up there, and they're trying to make sure they screen the general public out, and that they can get known, you know, friendly audience members in. That's always been happening in all these town halls, you know, all along. It's not unusual for a president or an official to try to skew the crowd their way. But there's been some regular citizens trying to show up, and they're pretty vocal, and they're actually getting intimidated by these SAU. And in one case, they beat the crap out of this black guy who was selling, like, anti-Obama buttons and stuff. And I don't remember what city that's in, but that's a case that's, I guess it's getting pretty heated. Maybe we're headed for another 1968, you know, where there's a lot of unrest in the streets. I hope we can avoid that, but if the leaders are flat out inciting their people, which it looks like Obama's doing, I don't hold out a lot of hope for give peace a chance, you know, if they're saying, like what they said yesterday, hit back twice as hard. I think they meant, you know, figuratively, you know, come back and shout back twice as hard for your side. But the analogies they use are pretty inciting. So I don't know. We'll see where it goes. I just when you hear rhetoric like this from these leading columnists and politicians, you got to wonder how much it's going to escalate. Oh, by the way, go ahead.
It's probably going to escalate once they manage to get some grassroots efforts going on their side. So I would think it would escalate so long as, you know, there's still support for the Obamacare plan.
Yeah, I hope the anti-statist side will just at least keep to their points and not get sucked into fighting. And I've heard people on Rush Limbaugh today, or one guy at least, saying, you know, I don't know how much of this we can take. I don't know, you know, before I start doing or thinking about doing something. You know, it's that kind of thinking, you know, that it's really ends up discrediting your side. If you're going to go and start wrecking things or shooting things or blowing things up, you know, you're going to bring more government ultimately down on your head and everyone else's. So it's very,
absolutely,
it's very counterproductive. And I think we got to be pretty strong and get out there and be vocal and not be afraid to give our opinions. But, you know, if you just get so frustrated that you're going to start blowing things up, then that's, you know, obviously going to, you know, that's the kind of crisis they love. Actually, you're sucking them into the fight that they want. They love the crisis. If we haven't noticed that already, they've used crisis to pass so much government in the last year, or even going back to 9/11.
Especially 9/11.
Yeah, the Patriot Act and all kinds of, you know, kind of draconian, you know, policies in foreign policies, and ignoring, and, you know, any agreements we had, and multilateralism is all kind of gone. And, you know, you pay a large political price for that kind of attitude. If you think you have to have freedom from fear or freedom from want, eventually you're gonna trash the economy. So anyway, spent too long on that, but hey, let's switch.